In this presentation, we're going to be going over the radiographic positioning and procedural considerations for the small intestine. We primarily use barium or other opaque contrast administered one of three ways to evaluate the small intestine. We can administer it orally, which is most common, or we can administer it with reflux filling via large volume barium enema, or it can be direct injection via tube placed into the small bowel, termed enteroclysis. Patient preparation includes a soft or low residue diet for 2 days prior to the study, and all food and fluid withheld after the evening meal on the day before the exam. Breakfast is also withheld on the day of the exam, and a cleansing enema for the colon may also be administered. For the oral method of examination, it's termed small bowel series because several identical images are produced at timed intervals. Each image should be identified with a time marker indicating the interval since the ingestion of barium. Images are obtained in the patient either supine or prone. Supine images take advantages of superior and lateral shift of the stomach, which improves the visualization of the duodenum and jejunum. Prone is used to compress the abdomen and increase image quality. Compression usually means less thickness of the patient anatomy, therefore there's less scatter radiation produced, and less dose to the patient overall. The first image is generally taken 15 minutes after ingestion of the barium. The radiologist should inspect each image as the procedure varies according to the radiologist's preference. Once barium reaches the ileocecal region, fluoroscopy is used to obtain compression radiographs, which evaluate structure and function of emptying. The examination is complete when barium is seen in the cecum, which takes an average of 2 hours after ingestion, but can vary with patient motility. As mentioned previously, these views can be taken AP or PA, with the MSP centered. The initial image may include the stomach depending on the radiologist's preference, but generally the centering would be identical to a KUB. Center the MSP at the level of L2 or the iliac crest. A 14 by 17 field should be utilized, and the exposure should be made at the end of expiration. Here you can see the difference in 15-minute increments how the barium slowly fills the small intestine. You can see on the 30-minute film at the right that the barium has already entered the large intestine as we see it beginning to fill the ascending colon. At this point, the radiologist should be consulted to determine if spot film should be performed to visualize the terminal ileum. Here we can see the entire large intestine has been filled with barium through to the rectum. The images on the right are spot films taken by the radiologist to document appropriate spilling of contrast through the ileocecal valve and into the cecum.